Guess what? Game done fucked up again.
Well, game didn't done fucked up. Someone
Pliskin's technology done fucked up
someone
again.
Someone with some happy feet accidentally kicked the cord to the blue.
We're cursed with this game.
So, you probably just got done hearing, for the last half of the last episode, McDan monologuing, because I think that's how we're going to just handle that.
Yeah, I haven't actually done it yet, so even I don't know what I said. But I'm going to go ahead and say, I'm sorry.
it's what happens in the game. You gotta go up.
Son of a bitch. Oh, that's right, the fucking forest is down there. The forest full of buttholes.
Not that way. Up the stairs.
Oh, that's the fortress.
That's the sense fortress.
That's the fortress full of buttholes. So we got a forest full of buttholes and a fortress full of buttholes.
So, yep.
And now I have to go to a church full of buttholes. Yep. A.K.A. a church.
And you get to fight your first Black Knight.
Yay. Is the sarcasm obvious enough?
Right. So now that it's officially a new episode, we can start talking about what we wanted to talk about.
Starbucks!
So on this episode... Do not forget to put in parentheses Star Wars spoilers ahead or something. So don't. I mean, it's probably.
Oh, please. Even the 501st Legion, that Stormtrooper organization, even they lifted their restrictions on spoilers, alright? It's. By the time this video comes out, if they haven't seen Star Wars, they deserve to be spoiled.
That is true. It's going to be probably in the next 2 weeks this comes out, so.
So who hasn't seen Star Wars?
If you haven't seen Star Wars...
Raise your hands. We will see it. We promise.
We will see it, and then when you get home at night, we'll be under your bed.
Forcing you to watch Star Wars.
That's so satisfying.
Which one of you told me that the Blu-ray of the original movies unaltered is coming out?
I did. I just saw that on Facebook 2 days ago.
And this is completely legit.
Yeah.
Imminent tough enemy.
Thank God.
Right. Black Knight, and you have to coax him all the way back to that bridge.
Holy shit!
Fuck that shield! Wow!
Yep.
Hopefully you didn't pull a boomerang too, because you got pretty far back.
Oh, fuck!
Keep him in front of you, though. See where he's at. Oh, he's coming. How about we wait until after he fights his tough enemy so we don't distract him?
Oh, God. I fight him just like any other.
Yep, just keep him in front of you. It's now attack.
Oh my God!
Oh, good.
Will my shield actually block his shit?
Yeah, but I won't trust it. Because we saw what happened. This is the easiest Black Knight in the game, though. Because look, he's dead.
Yeah. You massively oversold how scary that would be. Titanite shard, can I go level up again?
No, you need to now.
Son of a bitch.
So you need to... Boulder Knights drop it eventually. Kind of sometimes too.
Mo levels, mo problems.
So let's go around and see what everyone thought. So,
Before we say anything, let's rate our Star Wars fandom and how much do we know about the decanned expanded universe before we went into this movie?
Obviously we've all watched all six films, so we know that, and we've watched them.
Seven.
Well, seven now, but six previous movies. Get the thing behind you first before we fight them. Do not burn it, though. You need that for later. It's a soul, but it's a special soul.
The body of Christ?
Basically.
Amen.
Now you can fight the Boulder Knights. No. Don't. Remember that fucker?
Yeah?
Yeah, don't go over there. Otherwise, you're just gonna get fucking owned. Let's unlock this shortcut quick. Yeah. You gotta step on it. There you go. So basically, we've all seen all six previous films to date, besides this one. Willard, you go first.
I have read most of the Star Wars novels that take place after the decanon universe novels.
The Legendary
series. Yes, the Legendary series that take place after Return... That take place after A New Hope all the way to the Legacy of the Force, except for, like, a few novels here and there. And I played a lot of the video games, such as Rogue Squadron and Shadows of the Empire.
Can I go next? Otherwise you guys are going to make me look like shit.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, obviously I've seen... all seven movies. I've played some of the video games, Rogue Squadron Pod Racer. What the hell was the one with...
Shadows?
Shadows of the Empire.
I think everyone's played it, and if you have it, you should. And you should feel bad.
Yeah,
Also, Rogue Squadron, both of those for the N64,
yes,
were amazing games.
They were great games. Let's see, what else? I read a couple of the books. I read a lot of the guides, like the guides to alien species and like the cutaways of the ships and stuff like that.
I read a lot
of them. And
because this guy's a pain in the ass.
Yeah. And I saw the holiday special, and I saw both of the two Ewok spinoff films.
Actually, I own those.
That's amazing. Because from what I remember, even when I was like 8, they weren't very good.
I own them.
And I've seen some of Clone Wars, and that's about it.
So, my experience, not fully, but my experience spans from 10,000 before New Hope all the way through 195 after New Hope. So basically, I can't remember what the title of the comic was, but the origins of the Jedi.
Come and get me, bitch.
I know the story you're talking about.
Yeah, basically where they didn't really have space travel, but they were still using the Force.
Come and get me.
Glug quick, because this guy will own you. And then all the way up through Legacy of the Force with Cade Skywalker.
I'm trying to
who
get...
Who is Luke Skywalker's great-grandson or great-grandson?
I was trying to aggro him without...
Just watch, because I think he can shoot through the window. No.
I was trying to aggro him without aggroing any of the little fucks.
Back up some. I think he'll chase you.
Come and get me, bitch.
Go around the corner.
Just start throwing your mama jokes at it.
Yeah. Oh, now I aggroed those fuckers.
That's fine. That's the only way to get him to come.
You only come by killing his minions?
Oh.
Just watch. He's gonna shoot at you. Heal. Luckily, the shield ate all that. Alright, I think we're good. I think all you got is that asshole, which he's shooting at you, so...
Can I block his spells?
No.
Shield?
You'll take less damage. You'll take little damage comparatively, but you'll still get,
So just go?
If you get close enough, he won't shoot spells anymore.
Oh, shit!
Well, never mind. Fight this guy first. See?
God damn! Where the fuck are they all coming from?
There's like 6 or 7 of them there. We got one more. And then you're... Oh, 2 more.
Jesus Christ!
3 more. Heal. But, again, this is one of those guys that disappear once you kill him, so... Hopefully you do kill him.
I like how you drag the dead bodies with you.
Just charge him?
Oh, after he shoots. So in between him shooting. Yeah, shield up. Hit him again.
Hit him when he's down.
There you go. Simple as that. Now you got a shit ton of souls. You might want to go back.
Yeah. Watch me ragdoll this big fuck.
Yeah. Alright, yeah, let's go back.
I'm taking him with me.
It's
funny, the last time we tried to play through this, I tried to take one of those rats with me.
Yeah.
I got pretty far with it. Look at this shit.
Oh, the ragdoll is great in this game. Dark Souls 2, they took that out.
Oh, that's...
But in Bloodborne, they brought it back. And trust me, the ragdolling in Bloodborne is fucking fantastic.
Illusory wall?
Illusionary wall? No, I don't think there's... Hit the wall. Hit the wall here. No, that's a lie. There's nothing there.
You lying liar.
I didn't think there was, but... Alright,
so the Black Knight doesn't come back, and...
And the fucker up above.
Spellzy McGee doesn't come
back.
Yeah,
so now you're clear to do whatever you want.
Woohoo! I'm gonna go find a dead rat and fuck it in the butt.
Okay.
So yeah, have fun.
See you next time.
Just getting your Star Wars knowledge.
So yeah.
Yes.
I know everything from 10,000 before New Hope to 195 after... hit and miss here and there. I've read all of the Yuvan stuff.
That's the New Jedi Order.
New Jedi Order. I've read all of...
The Yuuzhan Vong?
Yeah. I've read all of the stuff about...
See, I know that from my guides.
I know all that about Luke and his son being exiled and going and fighting a planet full of Sith, which I can't remember which...
That's the beginning of Legacy.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, level up.
I have the books at home.
What am I doing now,
Dick? Endurance. Now it's gonna be slow going, but that's alright.
See, you guys were lucky. You got into all this extended universe shit for things that you loved. My parents didn't take me to bookstores. They just put me in my room and left me there. And hoped I didn't break anything.
Did you read anything about Darth Plagueis?
Darth Plagueis?
Yeah.
No.
That's 2,000 years before New Hope.
Wait, isn't that the original...
That's the beginning of the Sith code of two.
Oh, isn't that...
the rule of two.
Yeah, isn't that
Because before that, there was so many Sith around.
But no, so we're going to talk about our opinions of the new movie.
So, Willard, go ahead.
Okay. Like I said, I have considerable amount of Star Wars knowledge. I've read a lot of the books, a lot of the games. I liked elements of the movie. I was entertained by it. I enjoyed it. The thing that bothers me is Disney deconned the EU and called it the Legendary Universe. And I am a trained writer, and I can understand why they wanted to do that. However, about a third of the things from the movie...
I need to take the ball right.
Yeah.
...initially came from the EU. So they deconned stuff when you started to use it. I think the authors of those books and the editors should have gotten a writing credit.
Which, maybe they did, I don't know.
No, I'm just saying, they should have gotten something that to acknowledge...
Jesus!
Oh, you can kill them in one now.
Nice. Their acknowledgement of what they did. Yeah. You know? Because... Now, Pliskin, what was your idea about the... How was your feelings about the movie?
Well, I will say this. As a movie, it's good. It's a very good movie. As a Star Wars film... My personal feelings is, no.
What are your reasons behind that?
Okay. The biggest reason why Star Wars is fun to me...
Ow.
...is not the... Like, the characters, yes. Obviously, the characters make Star Wars. But to me, it's about the universe. Learning every little bit about the universe you can. That's why I like the books. It's why we all got so enthralled in the first place with the movies.
I didn't. I got into it because it had spaceships and robots.
The universe. Learning about the universe.
I got into laser swords and laser swords.
By the way, am I the only person here young enough that they got into Star Wars?
By the way,
what?
You go down there, so you can open up that gate.
Am I the only person here who's young enough that they got into Star Wars because they saw Muppet Babies?
Oh my god, I know what you're talking about.
I know what you're talking about too.
No, I got into Star Wars because I rented Return of the Jedi when I was like 4. At my local video store that I haven't seen any of the other Star Wars movies.
Oh, dude, that sucks.
I'm 4. You have to keep this in mind. I'm like 4
Open
or 5.
Open that gate up so you can shortcut it.
And,
you gotta go around the side.
What happened...
That was the lever.
...was I was enthralled because it was laser swords...
God damn it!
...base battles. The older I got, the more I was able to appreciate it.
Dude, epic space battles are one of the reasons I love DS9.
Yeah, but Pliskin, how did you get into Star Wars?
Well, my parents had the original VHSs unaltered, and we watched the shit out of them until basically they didn't work anymore.
I love that story.
But no, I saw clips of it on Muppet Babies, and I was like, oh, that's cool. And then when I was 6, my parents took me to Disney World and took me on the Star Wars ride, and I was like... Holy shit, you mean they're actual real movies? It's not just random shit Muppet Babies came up with?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Interestingly enough, Muppet Babies was produced by George Lucas.
Yeah. I went home and begged my parents to rent all of them.
You might as well go back and buy some shards and just level up the sword to +10. +9.
Buy some shards?
Yeah, because you can buy them for 800 a piece.
Ah, nice.
So, Pliskin, so tell us more
I can level up to
about
+9?
Your...
The sword,
age.
Yeah.
About your feelings on the movie.
Okay.
Since you...
So, I don't think it's a good Star Wars film, because in my mind, when you talk about Star Wars, you can talk about specifically movies, because I mean, that's why we're, you know, that's the main focus of Star Wars, is the movies, not the books, not the comics, the movies. I want a universe.
What the fuck was that?
When someone lights a bonfire next to you, you can act dressed as Flask.
Ah, nice.
When you talk about Star Wars and you get a new film specifically, I want to know more about the universe. I want something new. I want something completely new, which is why, even though the prequels were bad movies, they were good Star Wars films. Because they gave you something new. Every single one didn't rehash something. Every single one didn't come from something else. I didn't like this new movie because, literally, I'm going to quote Judge Drunk. Did you like New Hope? Because I fucking hope so.
Yeah, how about not?
Because literally...
Not to Star Wars, but to that.
Yeah. Because literally, this... The Force Awakens... Mirrors New Hope almost exactly, shot for shot. And what they don't use shot for shot, they steal from the EU.
How do I
purchase item? Titan shirts, there you go. Boom. Just buy one for now.
And this will take me up to 9? Oh, well, no, plus 5.
Plus, eventually. So, reinforced weapon, 3-hander. That'll take you to plus 3.
Should I get more?
You can only get one more. I mean, you may, yeah, go ahead and buy it, because you might get one for the Baldur Knight. So, you can't upgrade it again. You only have one, you need two.
Oh, son of a bitch.
So, go sit at the bonfire and do it all over again. In fact, you have one humanity, so if you want to burn it to kindle these fires, since this is going to be very important, you can. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay.
Kindle.
Well, you gotta reverse your problem first.
Son of a bitch.
Anyways, so to me, the Star Wars film was kind of a failure because we didn't learn anything new other than the fact that you gotta burn one in your item inventory, so you get close on that. Besides the fact that basically the only new thing is Luke went missing into hiding and everyone's trying to find him, whether to destroy him or get his help. We're doing something to find them.
Which, you know, they did this in a couple of the books before.
Yeah.
Luke decides that he needs to go into seclusion because shit got too real for him and he needs to deal with it.
He'll walk around and do it again.
And people are like, need to try to persuade him to come out of seclusion.
What do you mean walk around and do it again?
Go fight more people so you can get souls to upgrade your sword.
You know,
the grinding begins.
Yeah.
So it's just one of those things where, even though it's not the same, Luke did go into seclusion when shit got too real for him.
Yeah.
Because if you ever read the books, he dealt with a lot of messed up shit.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Doesn't his wife die?
Yes. But at the hands of his nephew. And then in the books, he decides that he's
AKA Kylo Ren.
Yeah, Kylo Ren, whose name is Ben.
AKA Kinda Ren.
Ben, I mean not Ben.
See what I did there?
Yeah.
Kinda tell Ren. Us who Ben is in the novels.
Ben's name is not Ben Solo in the movies. In the movies, or in the books, he is Ben Skywalker. Ben is the name of Luke and Mara Jade's kid.
So they just revert, and it makes no sense why Han and Leia would name their son Ben.
If you want to be really technical about it, Ben was never Obi-Wan's name in the first place. Maybe they just liked the name Ben. Maybe it's a coincidence.
No, his birth name was Ben.
Was?
Yeah.
Well, then where did Obi-Wan come from?
Jedi name.
Anakin didn't get a Jedi name. Luke didn't get a Jedi name.
I think, if I remember right, from Obi-Wan's origins... Obi-Wan is an alien. I want to say, if I remember right, Obi-Wan is one of the alien names or words for wisdom.
Jesus Christ.
Well.
Because obviously Obi-Wan was very wise. Even at his young age in episode 1, he was wise.
In the original context, before Lucas changed his mind... Obi-Wan, in the original storyline that he wrote, was Obi-Wan's name was Ben. Obi-Wan was kind of the nickname, which you brought up.
Nice.
Boom.
And Owen Lars was actually supposed to be
up there to get more souls.
Obi-Wan's brother.
Up the stairs.
And he put Luke in the custody of his brother to keep him safe.
Well, yeah. Owen is Anakin's stepbrother.
Yes, but in the original storyline that Lucas told everyone.
Yeah.
Before he changed his mind, it was supposed to be Obi-Wan Kenobi's brother.
Yeah.
But then he changed his mind and it wasn't. Because that's what George Lucas does. He changes his mind.
Fucking a lot.
Yep.
I mean,
I have to say, one change I did like was in 2011, the most recent ones that they put out digitally. Like, they just came out digitally this year, but they were the most recent DVD version from 2011. Guess what?
What?
Have you seen them?
No.
The Ewoks blink now.
That's actually kind of cool.
It is cool, because I don't know about you, I found them not blinking to be incredibly unnerving.
I guess that was due to the makeup, though.
It was due to the costumes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The only thing that moved on the old costumes was the mouth.
I mean, Michael Keaton made a comment when he was in the remake of RoboCop. The guy was complaining about the suit. He said, "You have no right to complain about the suit till you've been Batman."
Yeah, I can see that.
He's like, but no. So, what else didn't you...
You know what's awesome? Somebody asked Michael Keaton about Ben Affleck playing Batman. And like, oh, Christian Bale is super jealous about it. Do you ever get that way? And Michael Keaton says, no, because I'm Batman.
But no. So, Pliskin, what else didn't you like about the movie? Like, what...
I'll say what I liked. How about that? Because I don't want to sit here and criticize something. That's not me.
Oh, since when?
Well, I don't like to criticize things too hard. I liked Finn.
Again, since when?
Okay. You liked Finn. What did you like about Finn?
Finn's origin stories. Basically, Finn in this movie is the audience advocate. He is the one that basically... go behind you. There's a dude in the next room.
I'm not fighting that hook hands dude yet, am I?
No. Not until you level up your sword a little more. I think it's in here. Nope, I was wrong. It's later on. Anyways, there's a guy in a barrel that has some souls, but I thought he was around here. Mm. It's not. Anyways, so I liked Finn because he's your audience advocate, and he's obviously one of the main characters, which is the thing that people need to know, that Finn and Rey split the role of main character, which, I mean, it's nothing new for Star Wars. I mean... When you talk about the prequels, they did that all the time. It was Anakin, Obi-Wan, Padme.
And in the originals, it was Luke and Leia.
Well, straight up in the originals, you could say there was one main character.
Oh, which was Luke.
Everyone else kind of took like the side role. But in the prequels, like you cut away to each person, and they have their own story. Like obviously, like in Episode 1, you had Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan, and then. You cut away to Anakin sometimes, doing whatever Anakin did as a boy. In Episode 2, you had Obi-Wan doing things, and then you had Anakin and Padme doing things.
Which really...
Gaty. Doing things.
Yeah.
Doing Gaty. Things. Making baby Jedi.
I would say the only prequel movie that was more focused would be 3, because 3 was pretty much about Anakin.
Oh, definitely.
So the fact that they split the role between two people... That doesn't bother me. They've done it before. It works.
All right, I'm going to disagree with you here that Finn was the audience advocate because he's not. Rey is. The idea behind an audience surrogate, an audience advocate, is that they're relatable. Finn has been programmed from birth to be a stormtrooper. He's not relatable. Rey, on the other hand, is living in the middle of nowhere with fucking nothing to look forward to. That is relatable. Except more of the same.
Wait. But it's already been done. Rey follows exactly. Like if you say, "All right, who does Rey follow in New Hope?" It's Luke.
And there's so many people who do the same thing. And guess what? They're the audience advocates. Look at literally like almost every Doctor Who companion. Like they leave a normal life and they go off on adventures, and they're happy because normal life sucked.
But when it comes to Star Wars, I'm talking about someone who basically doesn't know anything about the universe.
Well, I would.
Oh, you need three now.
You know what?
Ray didn't know anything about the universe. She knew Jakku. That's it. Finn knew a hell of a lot about the universe because he would have to learn about what kind of shit he'd have to fight and endure as a stormtrooper.
Or no, it wasn't that he didn't have enough. I think it was. What the fuck? I don't know why.
You know what? It's an interesting thing about who was the audience advocate, because you have Rey, who knows nothing about the world.
Go back to the blacksmith for a second. I'm confused about something.
Go on, Willer.
All that she knows is living in a battle, in a former battlefield, where the rebellion and the Empire had a hell of a battle. Uh-huh. She's living in downed Star Destroyers.
That is meaningful, would you?
So.
Tenet Shire compared to what? I thought you had three of them, or did you just upgrade?
I just upgraded.
Oh, okay.
Graded.
Okay, never mind that. I'm just being stupid.
You know, she knows this. She's waiting for her family to come back.
But she doesn't know from where.
She doesn't know from where. She doesn't know. So she. You know.
All she knows is her life on Jakku. Just
yes, like, I mean, she knows.
Scavenging shit and getting food for it. That's it. That's all knows,
she knows. She's heard the rumors that this thing happened. That Luke Skywalker may or may not have existed. Obviously, Han Solo, she knows who he is. So she knows things.
When I think of an audience advocate in the Star Wars universe,
it has to be somebody relatable.
It's
no matter what movie it's in, because Luke was relatable. Well, he was a farm boy.
This is why I'm saying. Hear me out. The Star Wars universe is big. You want someone who's basically learning along with the audience. Someone who's learning about the universe. Not necessarily who is the one that is just there and
we
can relate to. It's who is the one that you can relate to in the fact that...
But that's the thing. She didn't know anything about the universe, and guess what? Neither did we.
But, let me finish. Oh, someone invaded you, or is about to invade you. Because you can't go to the thingy.
To what thingy?
See, that's blocked off. That means you're about to get the message that you're invaded.
Oh, balls. I hope it's not another cheater. Just putting my back to
it
alone.
Yep. Okay, so this is interesting. I think Finn's the advocate because even on Jakku, he didn't know shit. Rey was the more competent one. She knew about Jakku. Finn literally didn't know anything because all he knew was how to be a stormtrooper. And at that, he wasn't good at it. So, like, he was bad at being a stormtrooper.
He knew nothing but being a stormtrooper.
When you drop him off and say, all right, your mind is basically... There he is. Ooh, you might be able to get a backstab on him because he's looking for you. Never mind. Just be careful fighting there. Is this going to be a serious fight or is he going to be a jumper? Just be patient. Oh, he's got bleed on it. Be careful with that. You can't take too many hits or you're going to bleed. Yeah. He's going to let you heal. Nope.
He's so far away from me, though.
If you die, do you lose everything that you've done?
Yeah, but he's so... Oh, well, now you can't heal. Or maybe you can't. I don't know what that is. That's alright. That guy was too advanced for you. Because he had shit going on.
Do you just lose everything you've done? All your upgrades?
Mm-mm. No. Because...
Everything since the last bonfire.
Yeah, so all he's losing is his souls. Anyways... Finn is the audience advocate because he knows the least amount of the universe as of the beginning of the film.
False. He knows more than Rey does because in order to become a stormtrooper, you have to learn how to fight a variety of enemies.
Here's the thing. It looks like the stormtroopers, though, from what we've seen, are very compartmentalized. They are infantry soldiers that go in and kill. Their lives are expendable.
Well, they're not just infantry soldiers. They play the role both of infantry and military police.
Basically, all that stormtroopers know in this universe, because they're brainwashed, is how to kill. They're not taught anything about the world. They know the mission, and that's it.
I mean, I think the stormtroopers during the rebellion probably are more the type of stormtroopers that Dan's talking about, McDan's talking about. Because those are the people that are going up against guerrilla warfare. They are not going up against a straight battle.
Yeah, because soldiers, they don't just learn how to shoot a gun. I mean, they learn all kinds of shit.
But you got to think about it. These soldiers...
Like snipers have to learn physics. They have to learn... You know why snipers are so dangerous? Not because they have the biggest guns, but because they've learned how to weaponize math. That's why snipers are dangerous. And in order to weaponize math, you need to know math. So just because he's a soldier doesn't mean, you know, he knows less than the average person.
But at the same time, they...
Go to the parish.
Oh, yeah.
They do make comments. He is brainwashed.
If anything, he knows more than the average person. I mean, he knows how to shoot guns on a TIE fighter.
Well, actually, he doesn't. He kind of wing it.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's true.
But, I mean, I think we're depend. He's also a new stormtrooper. So he doesn't have...
Yeah, he's a fresh recruit. Basically, the only thing he had was the brainwashing.
He wasn't a fresh recruit. He was trained from birth.
No, but what I'm saying is that was his first...
It was his first battle.
Yeah.
So...
And you think in 18 years of training, all he learned how to do was shoot a blaster?
Honestly, in the New Order, I think so. The New Order seems very, very much like... Well, straight up. Nazi regime.
He was taught to do one thing, and that is to shoot a blaster and kill.
Yeah.
Well, he wasn't... It doesn't take 18 years or however old he was to learn...
Yeah, but the mental conditioning so you don't betray the...
Oh, there's probably a... Nope. Never mind.
That's probably what it was.
Go up the stairs.
You probably had to go through 18 years of propaganda.
Well, not only that, but I mean, you're talking about literally taking the human mind and breaking it down.
Well, they do that in real life in much less time. I mean, you've got, Jesus Christ, 12-year-olds in Afghanistan who pick up bazookas and shoot at American soldiers.
Yes, but they still have free will. How many of them turn tail? Probably, yes, 3 out of 10 probably shoot the gun and have no remorse. But how many of them turn tail and eventually get themselves shot? Like,
you mean like all stormtroopers eventually get themselves shot?
Well, yeah, but it's not because they've turned tail, it's because they're doing their duty. Like, Finn was the first one out of the whole program, according to the Star Wars film, that basically fought off his brainwashing. Because Fantasia, or whatever her name is.
Phasma.
Which, by the way, she was probably one of the most disappointing characters in the film.
Right. Did you know that's that chick from Game of Thrones?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, apparently
and
in
she
next...
actually is that tall.
Uh-huh. Apparently in the next movie she's going to have a much bigger role.
Well, I hope so.
I was thinking they threw her down the garbage chute.
They did, but she comes back by the end of it. You see her.
Yo,
did
you?
I didn't see her.
Yeah, she's going to have a much bigger role. They've already confirmed it. They didn't know how popular that she would become. It was one of those characters that they threw in there.
Oh, maybe the guy in the barrel's like right here.
That they realized, they became popular.
Yeah.
Like Boba Fett.
Okay, actually, no. She was disappointed she had no roles. The one that had the most role that I thought was disappointing was Chewie. Here's why. One, in this, just go back. Unless you want to kill that one Baldur Knight on the way to Hook Hands.
Yeah, I'll do that, because he might get me a...
No, not up there. Go down the hallway that was in that other room.
Spoilers for people that don't know this. In the books... They killed Chewie in 1999.
Yeah, well, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about Chewie.
He died saving Kashyyyk, right?
No, he died saving the Solo twins.
Yeah. He died saving Han and Leia.
And the kids.
No, Han and the kids. He pretty much performed his life debt.
Yeah. He's dead. So now you can go back and...
What's up there?
Hook Hands.
Oh, yeah.
So basically,
the gargoyle's up the ladder, isn't it?
Yeah. So the reason why I'm not a big fan of Chewie in this movie is because Chewie is a badass. He is that guy who's lovable, but he's also competent. He fucks shit up.
He is Captain Badass.
What does he do in this movie? Comic fucking relief.
Okay.
Well, he did.
He gets injured not once but twice.
He did it in the movies too. My girlfriend and I just binge-watched the original trilogy all the way through the night before we saw Force Awakens. And the scene in Return of the Jedi, where he's in the AT-ST and he opens it up and pokes his head out and goes, "Rrr," she starts laughing hysterically.
Well,
she starts laughing hysterically, and I said, "What?" She goes, "He's just so proud of himself."
Yeah, and that's the thing, is that he's doing it because he's like, I just did this. What now?
You
like,
know,
he was a badass.
You know what scene I love with Chewie?
Well, hold on. Okay. Let me finish my thought. So, Chewie in this film...
I might be able to buy 3 Titanite shards. Yes, I can.
Yeah. He's a goof. He gets injured once, and he cries like a baby because he got injured.
Well, to be fair, he wasn't injured in any of the other movies. We don't know how he would react to being injured.
But he was more fearless in the other movies. He followed Han chasing the stormtroopers in New Hope. This is a brave Wookiee. Like, he would not go and just react the way he did to a blaster shot to the arm. I just don't think he would. Also, when he gets patched up the second time and talking to the nurse,
and he's like, hitting on her?
Yeah, he's hitting on her. And he's like, yes, I know you were brave, And like, Chewie's kind of like, hey, I was there too and I was brave. Like, no! Why? And the fact that...
Because he's so proud of himself. Like, when he stole the ATST.
But that to me is different, because he's just like, look at what I did. And this is just kind of like, hey, I was there too, guys. It didn't feel right to me. Also...
It was basically him going, look what I can do!
New Yoda... Is Chewie's girlfriend?
What?
Don't you remember?
Oh yeah, where's the...
New Yoda's like,
what the
so
fuck?
Where's my boyfriend?
Oh, I don't have enough.
Yeah, you gotta get more souls.
How would that sex work?
I don't even want to think about it. The fact that
don't even think about it.
But
you know
I
like
Mary
Chewie. There's probably already a Rule 34 out there.
Yeah.
You know what? I like Mary Chewie from the novels with him having a family.
People from... You know what? He might not actually...
Oh, someone ring the bell.
She might not actually be his girlfriend. Because you know how many creepy old ladies are like, where's my boyfriend?
You think she just has the hots for Chewie?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I don't think they're legitimately, like, dating. I think she's just a pervy old lady.
Well, needless to say, I Chewie's characterization in this movie, I just... There's things about it I was just...
Well, I do like when he detonated the bombs.
Yeah. I also felt that his reaction to Han dying was a little meh.
Like, not good or, like, undersold?
Undersold.
That might have been the writing of the script, and also that could have been editing. We don't know what could have fit off the cutting room floor.
Because, yes, Chewie did...
We also don't know what Chewie did when off camera.
Also, yes, Chewie went and shot at Kylo Ren. But, I mean, you're talking about a guy who would... rip your arms off for losing at Star Wars chess.
Yeah.
Why would Chewie not take a leap at Kylo Ren?
Maybe
and fucking...
He's getting older. You don't know what the lifespan of a Wookiee is.
400 years.
Well, how old is he?
200.
That's practically middle-aged. My dad's not going to go sprinting down the street.
Here's the other thing with Chewie. Chewie probably helped raise that kid. He could just be in shock.
It's true.
I mean, Chewie is probably that
God
kid's
damn
baby.
It!
Chewie is probably that kid's babysitter.
Rocky IV freeze frame ending.
Well, think about it, though. His life did the Han. You don't think he watched the kid? You don't think he was like...
Oh, absolutely.
He played with that kid? You don't... You know, he was there when that kid was growing up.
He was Kylo Ren's big space teddy bear.
What would you do? Well, how do you think that he felt? Watch... I mean... Here's this person that you helped raise.
It's like you watching your little brother kill your dad, essentially.
I can see that.
I mean, or, you know, he probably... You know, I'm hoping in the next movie they deal with Han's death a lot better.
Yeah, it
there like, wasn't much of an opportunity.
No.
And we have to keep in mind that... You know, they can't completely shoot their load on this movie because it's supposed to be the first movie in a new trilogy.
You know what I want to see?
I mean, yeah, they shot their load in A New Hope, but that's because it was supposed to be the only Star Wars movie.
I want to see, because the books, the opposite happened, Chewie is one to die. I want to see Alcoholic Chewie. Because you know what happened to Han after Chewie died?
He became an alcoholic?
He became an alcoholic and he just became a worthless piece of human shit for a while.
And he actually hit Leia at one point.
Yeah, like...
Seriously?
Yeah, yes. He like wiped Leia.
Yeah, like he
like
became,
repeatedly or just lost it once and hit her?
Just
and
once.
Like, yeah, like he lost himself. Like
did,
Han...
Was, did he become like immediately regretful and just run away?
Yeah.
Or?
Yeah.
He like, felt... bad.
All right, I've got enough.
He felt Yeah, he felt really bad about what happened, but he lost his shit.
So it's gonna be fun. Honestly, it's gonna be a challenge because I mean, how do you put any more expression on the costume's face that Chewie has?
Not unless you computer animated and nobody wants that.
No. Like, how do you show a sad Chewie now? It's going to be interesting to see. Because, I mean, Chewie and Han, they're best friends. They're not just life-dead partners to each other.
Yeah, they're life partners. Rule 34.
Yes, yes. But, I mean,
You think Chewie's the pitcher or the catcher?
I'm going to say he's the pitcher.
Anyways, Chewie and Han are best friends.
I don't know. His life debt is to Han. Maybe Han calls in the life debt so he gets to
At this point, I think early 20s, or not early 20s, in his teenage years, is when Han saves Chewie's life. Han Solo, the book, explains what happened.
Han Solo was his backstory if they follow the book, which they... He was an Imperial officer.
Is Zweihander 5 enough to go fuck that guy up?
Yeah, he should be fine.
He was an Imperial... What was he, a lieutenant in the Imperial Navy?
Yes.
And Han was an orphan-ish. And he was a lieutenant, which is... He was pretty prestigious, if you think about it, to be a lieutenant in the Imperial Navy.
Yeah. Actually, hold off. We're going to talk about this in the next episode.